In this video, I'm going to be talking to you about how to use min and max as an alternative to if function. I'll also tell you why you should do that, but let's use this example to understand what we're trying to do. Let us say I bought an asset with a purchase price of 800,000 and with a salvage value of 50,000. The time of purchase is 0.75 of a year. That's the 9th month. Let's say at the end of the 9th month is when I'm buying it. And we expect the life of the asset to be 8 years. So which means the asset will be disposed of 8.75 years from now. You buy it at the end of 9th month, that's 0.75 years. 8 years from there on, it's 8.75 years, right? So in terms of the time use, let's say what I'm trying to achieve is this. Because I bought it at the end of 9th month, in the first year, I can't depreciate the full 93,750. The reason is that I'm using it only for 0.25 of a year, right, for only 3 months. So I have to figure out how much time I used this asset in a particular year. So the first year, I'm going to use it for 0.25 of a year. Subsequently, I'll be using it for full years. And the last year, which is my 9th year, I'm going to be using it for 9 months, or that's 0.75 of a year. Now, how do we make our Excel get this data automatically? One way to do it is to use an if function. So here I have an if function where the condition we're testing is this. If the year is the first year, then first year minus the time of purchase, that's the time for which you are using the asset. For subsequent period, all the way before the 9th year. So we are checking whether the year is less than 8.75 or the end year. If it's before that, then it's pretty simple. You're going to use it for 1 year. The 9th year, I'm going to use it for 0.75 of a year. Right? So, but how do I identify whether this is the 9th year or this is the last year? Two conditions has to be satisfied. One is the year number should be greater than the ending year. So 9 should be greater than 8.75. But at the same time, the year number should be less than 1 plus 8.75 or 1 plus the ending year. So 9 will be less than 1 plus 8.75, which is 9.75. So 9 will be less than 9.75. If these two conditions are satisfied, then that's the 9th, last year, correct? Because my 10th and 11th years will also be greater than this 8.75, but 10 will not be less than 9.75, which is 8.75 plus 1. Our little logic seems pretty confusing, right? That's precisely the reason why you should not use this if function. Let's get rid of it. But what's the alternative? This if function looks pretty confusing. What's the alternative? Here is where the min and max functions can help us. How does the min function help? I'll take you through step by step because unlike if function, min function is not very intuitive for a lot of us. So I'll take you through step by step. So in the first year, what do you want? We want it to be 1 minus the time of the purchase, right? Which is 1 minus 0.75. That gives us 0.25. But when I apply the same calculation in subsequent years, it becomes 0.25 becomes 1.25, then 2.25 and so on. But that doesn't make sense because in a year, you can use an asset only for 1 year. So this number cannot exceed 1. So what am I going to do? Anytime you think a number should not exceed a cap, in that case, what you can do is use a min function, right? Because if my value goes above a cap, it can be pulled down using the min function. So that's what I'm going to do here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, you know, let this calculation be there, but this value cannot exceed 1. So let me type that 1, B11 minus D4. Great. Now we've got this. Not really. Because in the 9th year, when we look at it, it still gives us 1. But in the 9th year, if you look at it, which is the last year, it should only be 0.75. So what I'm going to do is, in 9th year, what should be the answer? So I want 8.75 minus 8. And how do I specify this? So let me select this 8.75, end time of the asset. Minus 8. What is 8 here? 8 is going to be 9 minus 1, right? The year minus 1. So that's going to be minus 9 minus 1. In this case, I could remove the brackets and I could also write it as minus 9 plus 1. So that gives me 0.75. We are still not done because, again, let me copy paste this across from the first cell onwards. It gives me negative number subsequently. Now, how do I fix this? Pretty simple. What I'm going to do is, now here's our catch. The value should not go below zero, right? So we have a floor here. And when you have a floor, what you can do is use a max function. So that when a value goes below the floor, the max function will pull it up, because it's going to return the maximum of whichever value. And what's our floor here? Zero. So I'm going to use max of 0, comma whatever we have here. And let's copy paste this. We've got the solution, right? I agree. Min and max together is not something very intuitive for a lot of us. If function is more intuitive. So you might be wondering, now, why should I use max and min when I can use if function? There are two reasons. One is, once you get used to it, min and max is far simpler than if function. Let's just look at size of the formula, right? Let me just pull out the size of the formula here using the formula text function. This is the size of the max and min combined. And this is the size of our if function. This is not even 50% in size, much smaller formula, right? Takes time to get used to it, because as I said earlier, it's not intuitive. But look at the size, it's so small. But it's not just about the size of the formula. You know, if it's only about size, I would say, you know, it's okay. But it's not just about the size, it's also about accuracy. If function, because of so many conditions, it a lot of time obfuscates the logic. I mean, it kind of makes the logic a little vague. This looks like it works, right? Now, when I change my time to half year or 0.25 of a year, it seems to be giving correct answer. But sometimes it may not work. So what is the time of the purchase after first year? Let's say it is, I buy 1.5 years from now. The if function, which we thought was working earlier, now is giving me a ridiculously wrong answer. It tells me I use the asset for minus 0.5 of a year. No. I use it for 0 years, because if I didn't buy it in the first year, I didn't use it. Our max function could handle it without any issues. No doubt I can make the if function also handle this, but it's going to be pretty complicated. I'll have to probably add another 2 levels of nesting here. Right? So min and max put together can act as an alternative to if function. So just to repeat, use min function if you have a cap to your data. If you don't want your data to go above a level, we use min function. And you use max function if you want to apply floor to your data. If you don't want the value to go below floor value, use the max function. Alright. Depreciation is pretty straightforward. Once we get the time used, it's simply going to be time used times depreciation. And we are done. Alright. So hope you like the video. If you like the video, please spread the knowledge. Please share the video. Thank you.